So it's come to the seventh of the Pilates Qigong April K sequence. Again, Pilates style, we're doing this. So zipping up pelvic floor, scooping out abdominals. Quite a basic motion, it's like a punching motion. It's called punch it, it's got many different names, but punching with angry eyes to increase strength. Bit of a weird name because you're trying to do the opposite. It's helps the liver, which is linked to anger. That's where the name comes from. It's aiming to balance appropriate anger. So every organ's linked with an emotion or an element. And this, or the emotion that's linked to the liver on the right-hand side, not the left-hand, that's the spleen, is basically anger, and you're trying to balance that within that meridian. I won't get too much detail into the meridians and the organs. That's just going to do its work anyway. Just sort of explaining the name there. So again, basically, it's like a Carter horse riding stance, and you're just coming out here, which is seen in a lot of sort of karate stuff like that. There's a few adaptions on the one leg, etc., and the Pilates breath in with there. So there's a slight difference, but I'm going to go straight through the basic thing and just link it to motion. Remember, think tiny waist, brace yourself in abdominals, navel towards the spine, zip up pelvic floor. They go together anyway, them two. You can't do one without the other. And again, it's just breathing through the nose, exhaling through pursed lips. I'm going to go for the basic one. A few different versions. Hands can be here or here, wherever you like. Stance can be wide or shorter. You can just do it here. Exhaling out, breathing, coming back. Lengthen up for the crown as you do this. Zip up pelvic floor and scoop out your abdominals. If you want to sort of widen that stance, you can do and go to here and come down. So again, if you want to widen the stance, go to sort of feet hip width apart, squat stance there, exhaling down, breathing, coming back. Again, nice and simple there with that one. Exhaling down, breathing, coming back. If you're squatting, come no lower than knees in line with toes. Feet are sort of facing the front, not Charlie Chaplin, just facing forward. If you go a little bit wider in a horse riding stance, you might find a slight V with the feet. So, like I say, not completely Charlie Chaplin, slightly sumo, I like to call it, slightly to the side, like a V there. And you won't get this going on too much. Again, if you've got any problems with the knees, don't go there. Just come back to just using your arms. It can be a centimetre, a millimetre, or a foot, the squat. So exploit that range to make it as easy or as hard as you like. As with the speed, like I normally say, slow is harder, fast is easier. Exploit that range, speed, and tempo. I'll use low as the knees come in line with toes, no deeper. If you're in this horse riding stance, make sure the knees are central. If they're doing this, you might want to change something, shorten the range up here, back to a squat, or just using the arms, or just a millimeter squat, or a little bit bigger. It's fine where that is on you. Main thing is knees in line with toes here, squat position, horse riding stance, just central, definitely not knees coming past toes. Okay, again, same deal, exhaling down, breathing in, coming up, just calibrating, synchronizing the breath with the motion, integrate the breath with the movement. So that's quite basic. Again, the Pilates breath is in there with that. From here, if you're going to make this a little bit harder, then we come forward. Quite a different angle pose. So again, I'm going to just move around a little bit so you can see this. So again, exhale and breathe in. Again, from here, you exhale, same side leg comes up, and you kick out. Again, here, then breathe and come back. Again, same with the other leg. Exhaling and breathing and coming back. But that's a bit too much. You can keep that low, or you can just go exhale, breathing in again into a sort of cat stance and come back a little bit. So you can just exhale this leg and breathing, come back. Same side leg, same side hand. Exhale. You can swap it around so it's more contralateral, but I'll go into that in a minute. I'm just going to show you all the different variations. There's quite a lot. So again, exhaling down, breathing in, coming up. It's a breathing in, coming up. Same side leg, same side arm. Quite causes a little bit of instability. Just keep the hips square as you do it. Headlights on your hips, not searchlights, facing the front. Again, if you want to make that harder, you empty your leg a little bit higher. So you exhale to here, breathing, coming back. Again, like a Miyagi, sort of straight kick. Exhale, breathing, coming back. The hand starts supinated and it turns to pronated. So basically palm facing the ceiling, then it faces the floor. If you want to go a little bit higher, make that harder, gathering against the instability, root that lead leg in towards the floor, and you're gonna go here, exhale, breathing in. Exhale, breathing in. Again, you can have it out at an angle, or you can go here, straight out, in one motion. Marry up the hands with the feet, okay? So what you're aiming to do with this, exhale, breathing in. Okay, you've got to go higher and breathe in. Only go as high or as low as suits you. Again, exploit that range, speed and tempo. You need to go a little bit faster to make it easier, then do that. Again, I'm overemphasizing the breath. Again, from there, you might want to go one there, and you go round the clock doing it. So again, you go back, exhale, breathing in. Exhale, breathing in. Do it low or you can do it high. Exhale, breathing in. Again, if it's just low, you might just want to go exhale, breathing in. Again, you're keeping the same side or as sort of asymmetrical even as you can. Okay, again, so you go one here, one to the back, and then you go to the sides. Again, Yoko Geri to the sides. Knee as high as you like, and be just like a cat stance to the side, and then you exhale. Then you exhale the other way. Again, if you think of sort of like a cross, we've gone like a cross. Again, you can go in between at angles as well. So again, you can pretty much do round like the Union Jack. So again, you can just literally go exhale here, breathing in, coming back. Exhale here, breathing in, coming back. So to the front, but slightly to the side at an angle, and then go to the back at an angle to the side. So again, not here, it's slightly off. Exhale, breathing in. Exhale, breathing in. I'm keeping low there, but again, you can do one all the way around. So basically, you'll start here to the front. I'll do it all the way around the clock, so you can see it in sequence. When I come this way, because I need a bit of room. So again, it's going to be exhale, breathing in. Then right leg, exhale, breathing in. Okay, and then I'm just going to literally go round the clock. Okay, so again, it's going to be exhale to the sides. Okay, and then exhale to the sides, and then here at an angle. So again, exhale to the slightly off angle from the front, then exhale, and then go to the back, exhale. Again, if you want to go higher, I'm going to go higher. Breathing in, and then to the back at an angle, and breathing in, coming back. Again, I'm going high. You need to come back every time, shoulders over hips, head over shoulders, gathering against the instability, root that lead leg in towards the floor, as if you've got roots growing up and nourishing the body from the floor. Again, you can pretty much do it any way you like, just going around basically here, and the back, front, back, sides, and in the middle. If you want to do the same leg, you can go all the way around, and then come back and follow on round the clock, anyway, clockwise or anti-clockwise. Or we can do both. Again, that's just to get nice 3D motion. So we're stabilizing. We're not just in a sort of 2D plane, straight forward, straight back. We make it more functional. We go round. So we challenge ourselves to be able to stabilize all the way round the body, that transverse plane of the body, which we're challenging the stability all the way around there. So again, nice sort of 3D motion, that one. And again, you're just trying to marry up the hands with the feet. You can sort of do contralateral stuff. Again, it gets a bit confusing there with the coordination. You can go sort of opposite side, exhale here, and then you go to the sides. Again, opposite arm, opposite leg. That's how the body works, opposite palm to opposite heel. So this is slightly more functional. Again, exhale. Again, I'm going high, you wouldn't have to. And then exhale to the sides again. And then you go to the back again. Breathe in, exhale, breathing in. Again, you could go at an angle there, but again, I'm just giving you the gist of it. Just to vary it up, all the different angles there, gathering against the instability. You can do them any way like that, all the way around. Opposite side hand, or same side leg, same side hand. Again, that contralateral version is very functional, because that's the way we walk. We work from opposite palm to opposite heel connection. That's how the body works contralaterally. That's really good. Gathering navel towards the spine against that instability, and exploit that range, speed and tempo to make it as easy or as hard as you like. Whatever version you pick, just make it suit you. Again, it might be the easier versions or the harder versions. Remember, it's your Pilates and Qigong, so only make it as easy or as hard as you like. It's your union of your mind and body. Lovely. So that was number 7. So we got shake the back to eliminate 100 illnesses next. Lovely. Bang.